Yo, yo, yo. Come on. You and me are gonna go out there and kick some ass. You'll feel better.
Happy to help.
So, what are we doing out here exactly?
Just taking care of some business. Figured pitching in might make you feel better. Now we're gonna kill some zombies the old-fashioned way. Nice work. Things are looking up already.
Thank you. Well, go ahead, lead the way.
Let's roll. Nice. I'm loaded up. See you back at base.
We'll see you soon.
Don't let it get up! Okay, looks like no zombies were close by. Area secure. No Zeds here. Sit tight. I'm bringing this stuff home.
Roger that. We'll be waiting.
Zombies up ahead. Go through, go around.
Feeling better?
It's a possibility.
Look, you're not alone. Everybody's scared. Just don't do anything stupid, okay?
Yeah. Okay, sure. Zombies up ahead. Go through, go around. Zombies coming up behind us.
Okay. Looks like no zombies were close by.
Keep an eye on our six.
Area secure. No Zeds here.
Better get ready. We'll be on our own if we keep going this way. Zed's up ahead.
Lucky they didn't hear that.
We got Zeds at 9 o'clock.
that's gonna bring trouble.
I wanna swing wide. We got zombies to the left. Dude, help now, please! Heads up, we got zombie activity at 3 o'clock.
You're untouchable out there, man.
I don't think so. I'll run this home.
Roger that. We'll be waiting.
Heads up! We got zombie activity at 3 o'clock. Zombies coming up behind us.
I'm almost there.
Look, I appreciate your concern. Really, it means a lot.
Good. There you go. Don't say I never gave you nothing.
My hero.
Is it true? Is he like...
I'm afraid so. Fought like hell, but there wasn't no recovering from his wounds.
Oh. Was it, I mean, did he suffer?
He was unconscious for most of it. He only woke up a couple of times. He mentioned you at the end.
Thank you.
I'm picking something up.
Jack! Jack, do you copy? Damn it, man, where are you?
Sounds like they're in a bad spot. Might want to offer them a hand.
I saw a few of those army jeeps driving around while I was in Marshall.
That's great. You should go talk to them.
I don't know. Didn't look like they were doing much of anything, just driving around, watching.
What?
Nah, I wouldn't worry about it. I'm sure they're just the advanced scouts. The main force is gonna be here any day, and they're here to take care of us. Hey, would I lie to my favorite little sister in the whole world?
Attention survivors, only those who abide by the laws posted outside the courthouse are eligible for the protection of the Sheriff's Department. If you want to keep your guns and keep your own scavenge, you're on your own.
This looks like a good spot for an outpost.
Pretty big step. Sure you want to go through with this?
Let's do this.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll run this home.
We'll see you soon.
This is good, right? I mean, it doesn't. Okay, I'll run this home.
Roger that. We'll be waiting. So, the zombies really like that beacon, huh? I hope whatever you found out there was worth the risk.
This is Judge Lawton. Earlier today, our scouts informed me that they have identified multiple infestations in the downtown Marshall area. Based on this information, and for your own safety, I'm declaring a lockdown, effective immediately and until further notice. This is a matter for the police, and they will deal with it.
Jack should have known better than to go off alone.
You want to go home?
I didn't say that. Just, you should have known better is all.
Heads up, we got a visitor.
I'm loaded up. See you back at base.
We'll see you soon.
Off a little more than we could chew.
Happy to help.
We appreciate it. Last we heard from him, Jack should be somewhere in this vicinity. Let's get looking.
Watch behind us.
Look, I just think we gotta look at the big picture here. We all like Jack, but let's face it, the guy's probably dead. Keep an eye on our six. Anybody home?
I can't believe that noise didn't bring any zombies.
Holy shit, am I glad to see you guys.
You didn't think we were gonna leave you out here, did you?
How did you even find me anyway?
We had a little help.
I don't know what to say. I'm not sure I would have survived out here on my own.
Well, go ahead, lead the way.
Let's do this!
Watch behind us.
What happened anyway?
Oh man, I was stupid.
I was searching this garage for some gas for the generators when I heard some of those cops from the courthouse start coming up the street. I mean, I don't know, maybe they would have left me alone, but I heard those broadcasts. I didn't want to take any chances. So I jumped out the back window, and of course, what happens? I land right in the middle of a goddamn board. I managed to get clear, but they were right on my ass, and I was low on ammo. All I could do was hole up in an empty house and hope that they got bored.
That's our place. Thanks again for all the help. Hey, why don't you come inside? The least we can do is feed you.
Quinn. Oh, thank God. If you ever do something that incredibly stupid again, I will kill you, okay?
Hi, Becca.
Don't you hi, Becca, me with your aw shucks small town charm. I can't believe you. We need to stay close to home.
Jack could have died out there. I couldn't risk that.
No, you just risked everything we have by leaving this place undefended. But I'm glad you're home safe.
Well, you can thank our friend here for that. We'd have been in real trouble otherwise.
Okay, I admit it. I'm impressed. You happy? I just saw that truck again. I think they're watching us.
Any idea who they are?
No, but they're none of the people we usually trade with.
Hey, don't sweat it. If they try anything, I'll protect you.
Dude, I can protect myself just fine.
Okay, then. Well, you can protect me, too. I'm not proud.
courthouse and see what's going on.
Okay, I'll run this home.
We'll be ready.
Okay, I'll run this home.
Roger that. We'll be waiting.
Okay, I'll run this home.
Roger that. We'll be waiting.
Okay, I'll run this home.
We'll be ready.
Better do one more sweep. Make sure everything's clear.
Attention citizens, we've had reports of armed civilians attempting to force our patrols to provide supplies. Be advised that I have authorized all troops to respond to such measures with lethal force. For your own safety, remain in your homes and wait for this to blow over.
Something. It's pretty garbled. Let me see what I can do.
Don't trust the army. They don't care what happens to us. They're turning us out in the goddamn street. For all I know, this is all their fault.
All right, lady, that's enough. Off the radio.
Well, what do you suppose that was about?
Beats me. But I think I want to find out. I'm headed out.
You've been pushing yourself like crazy. Come home and get some rest.
So damn tired.
Talk to the boys if you're looking for a trade. I'm busy here.
We've been hearing some rumors on the CV. People out looking for supplies getting robbed. Stuff like that.
I see. And you're the law on this matter, are you?
More like a concerned citizen.
Well, your concern is noted. But we haven't had any problems here. We look after our own.
And you wouldn't know anything about this, would you?
Take a walk with me, will you? Let me see if I can't explain how things are. Funny thing about people, they don't much like to challenge their assumptions. Now me and my brother, we done pretty well for ourselves in all this. Other folks see that and, well, it is in the character of very few men to honor without envy a friend who has prospered.
Aeschylus said that. And an envious man is a man who will spread rumors about his neighbors.
Right. Because normally gun-running moonshiners are such upstanding citizens.
Because we're businessmen. It's all about seeing the long game. Rob a man, and he'll give you what he's got in his pockets. You sell him what he wants, though, what he needs, and he'll keep on coming back to give you everything he has.
Oh, did Aeschylus say that, too?
Here, let's ask Mickey. Mickey, our friend here's curious if we've been stealing from our fellow survivors. Seems there are rumors to that effect.
Shit. If we was, wouldn't be anybody to spread no rumors.
See? Nothing to it. Now why don't you run along, and if we hear anything, you'll be the first to know.
So damn tired.
Job denied it, but I'm pretty sure they know something about it, at least.
Perfect. Our friends and neighbors. What should we do?
I think for now, we just tell our runners to stay extra sharp. We don't want to antagonize the workers, so we don't have to.
All right, I'll let everybody know. You watch yourself out there, too.
Heads up! Coming in hot! There you go. Don't say I never gave you anything.
Shame about Maybelline.
Shame. I brought him into this world 20-odd years ago. Suppose it's only fitting I took him out of the boy loves something he'll eyes. The day his tonsils came out, you'd think he'd won the lottery.
So how did you remember that?
I remember all my kids.
This is bullshit. We're just trying to survive out here. You can't kill us for that.
Uncle Sam would seem to disagree with you there. Our orders are to evict squatters with lethal force if they resist. You resisted, so...
Just let us go. I got kids, man.
And yet you're out here, violating quarantine, unlawfully occupying people's homes. Great parenting.
Look, we're sorry, right? We're just trying to get by, same as everybody.
You got 30 seconds to get out of my sight. 30, 29, 28, 27, 26. This is about the biggest crock of horse shit ever.
We're done here, Sergeant. Tell your men to prep for evac and RTB.
Yes, ma'am.
Why don't you make yourself useful and go babysit those two?
Anybody home? Sit tight. I'm bringing this stuff home.
We'll see you soon.
Hey, are you in there? Anybody home?
What you want?
Why don't you come with me? We've got room.
Really? My God, thank you. Thought for sure we were gonna die out here.
Zombies up ahead. Go through or go around?
What did those soldiers want, anyways?
Yeah, beats the hell out of me. They just showed up, dragged us out onto the street, and sent in those guys in hazmat suits. Started taking a bunch of samples and talking about infection vectors and a bunch of shit I didn't understand. I think that woman was in charge, Captain Montresor or something. Not like...
Better deal with this first. You were saying?
I think that woman was in charge, Captain Montresor or something. Not like she even looked at us.
Okay, I'm free and clear. See you soon.
Got anything good?
I'll show you when I get there. That's it, right up there. Make yourselves at home.
Thanks. You don't know what this means to us.
Might want to head down to the courthouse and see what's going on.
Better do one more sweep. Make sure everything's clear.
All due respect, Your Honor, we're stretched too thin as it is. You got half my guys guarding the dispensary instead of out there pushing these things back.
I understand the difficulties, Sheriff, but I don't know what you expect me to do about it. We only have so many trained officers left, and I'm not comfortable with the prospect of arming civilians for this kind of work.
If you'd let me start training them,
We'll discuss this later, Sheriff. We have a visitor. Welcome. I suppose you've heard our broadcasts? Well, it's all true. We have a safe, secure society here, governed by the rule of law. Walk with me. I'll explain.
You have a society? I'm sorry. What exactly happened to the United States while I wasn't looking?
Look around. We're facing a disaster of unprecedented scale. We have no way of knowing how widespread it is or how long it will take federal authorities to respond. Until they do, we have to look out for ourselves. It may not be the most constitutionally traditional succession, but it's all we have.
All we have? The army's camped just across the river.
Yes, and other than vaguely threatening radio broadcasts, they've made no attempt to contact us or provide relief efforts to the civilian government. Meanwhile, ordinary citizens like yourselves are living in fear. Fear of the dead. Fear of the criminal element that sees this as an opportunity to prey on their fellow man. Fear of the uncertain future of our nation. But it doesn't have to be that way. And, of course, all firearms will be surrendered. Only duly appointed law enforcement officers are allowed to go armed.
Right. Well, thanks for the offer. But we're doing just fine on our own. And I'm damn sure not surrendering my weapon when the streets are full of flesh-eating dead people.
I'm very sorry to hear that. We'd certainly prefer it if people joined us freely, before the issue has to be forced.
Is that a threat?
Just a reminder that the Wild West doesn't last forever.
Don't take it personal. She's under a lot of strain. We're penned in pretty good by these things, and like you might have heard, we're short-handed. Tell you what, help me clear some of these problem areas out, and I'll vouch for you. Put in a good word, maybe set up some kind of trade arrangement. Feel like lending a hand?
Sure.
Hope you're geared up. We've got a few infestations to deal with. I hate to see the old girl like this.
Wait, what?
The town. Yeah. It's been on rough times for a while now. But it used to be a damn fine place to live. Raise a family.
Sounds good.
Of course, my wife didn't agree, but never you mind.
Yeah?
Well, she married a machinist,
Didn't like it when I became a cop instead. She finally had enough a few years back. Took our son to live in the city. It would be a more enriching environment for him.
I'm sorry.
Not your fault. I just hope things there aren't as bad as they are here.
That should do it.
About time things started looking up.
Let's do this.
Behind us.
Let's move. Nice. I'm lucky they didn't hear that.
Bad now. You should have seen Marshall in the first couple of days.
Okay, what's up?
Seemed like half the town was already dead or dying. And the other half was trying to cram into the courthouse for protection. Mayor Carson had got himself shot trying to cross the bridges. The city council was locked in a conference room and refused to come out. The police station was overrun. It was chaos. Judge Lockner stepped up, got us all organized, kept people from each other's throats. Well, maybe she's not technically the law of the land, but damn sure we'd all be dead without her. Of course, some folks can never see how good...
Mayday, mayday! Is anyone reading? We're trapped! Lots of zombies outside, and we're out of ammo! Don't know how long we can hold out!
Sit tight. Help's on the way. Come on. We can deal with the rest of these infestations later. We gotta help those people first.
Thanks. We owe you big time.
Don't you worry about it. We're happy to help. Yeah, I think we'll call it a day there. The rest of those infestations can wait a while. I appreciate the help, though.
I got nothing left. I'm loaded up. See you back at base.
Roger that. We'll be waiting.
I could use some food. Sit tight. I'm bringing this stuff home.
We'll see you soon.
All quiet here.
Somebody's broadcasting something.
You're hearing this? Could use some help.
Sounds like they're in a bad spot. Might want to offer them a hand. If you want to check it out, it's on your map.
Nice.
I'm loaded up. See you back at base.
We'll see you soon.
There. I'll take a look around. Located a zombie infestation. That's a lot of zombies. How are things on the home front?
Tense. People are starting to get antsy, what with the crowding and all.
I'll swing by when I get the chance. We'll talk about it. I think I've seen enough for now.
How the... Need something?
I need a breather.
We're clear.
Nice.
I'll run this home.
We'll be ready.
Where's he at?
According to the reports, he's up at the cemetery outside Spencer's Mill.
Hope he's not expecting to find new patients up there.
Finally, things are going our way. I don't know. There's just something satisfying about building.
Cannot believe you. You want to run away. Again.
Come on, Lily. That's not fair.
You're right. It's not. We've built a home here, and you just want to abandon it because things are getting tough.
Hey, what's going on?
I was just trying to tell Lily that we need to start looking for a new place to live. We're too cramped in here, and our runners keep having to go farther and farther from the church to find supplies.
Seems reasonable. Things have been pretty tight lately.
Fine. Then maybe you should bail on us too.
There you go. Don't say I never gave you anything.
Sweet.
Should we?
No. Let her cool down. She'll come around eventually. Might not be a bad idea to get out of here for a while, though. You feel like going house hunting?
headed out.
Be careful. There are a lot of infestations out there.
Thanks.
Time to go home.
I'm done here. Zombies coming up behind us.
We've got this place locked down. Here we are.
Okay, that's all we need. You saved my ass.
proud to ask for help.
To you. Thought them things had my number for sure this time.
What are you doing up here?
Paying my respects. That's Magina, right over there.
I'm sorry.
It was a long time ago. At least it spared her from seeing all this. Hell, she'd probably handle it better than I do. She always was the smart one in the relationship. Now, lately, I find myself coming out here more and more regular. Talking to her sets my mind at ease. Didn't figure on them things following me this time. Anyways, appreciate the help. You find your people in need of doctrine, you give me a call.
Hang on. I've got a transmission coming in, I think. Let me see if I can play it for you. Damn it, people, how many times do I have to tell you? We need sentries watching the approaches.
We're trying, but there's no good place to post sentries around here.
I guess we're gonna have to fix that.
I'm on the move.
Keep an eye out for infestations. There's a lot out there.
Better deal with this first.
Hey, do you think you could do me a favor while you're out there?
Happy to help.
It's... no, never mind, it's stupid.
Wait, what?
I've been packing up my dad's stuff, and I found a watch box. It's from the birthday present I got him when I was 12. This stupid little plastic thing with cartoon fish on it. I don't know why he kept it, but it kind of made me realize I don't have anything to remember him by. So, I was going to ask if you'd go up to where he died and bring me something of his. No, forget it. It's stupid. It's way too risky. I'm sorry I brought it up.
Damn, I'm tired.
How's it going?
I'm almost there. There you go. Don't say I never gave you nothing.
My hero.
considered.
Say, you want to see just about the coolest way to kill Zeds ever?
All things considered, I think we're doing pretty okay. Show those sons of bitches what's what.
Sit tight. I'm bringing this stuff home.
We'll be ready.
Sit tight. I'm bringing this stuff home.
Roger that. We'll be waiting.
They didn't hear that. I'll run this home.
Roger that. We'll be waiting.
Thank you. Damn, I'm tired.
Heard on the grapevine, no sweat. I'll help run interference while your people work.
Guess that's true, Ioya. I'll meet you out front. We need to build some watchtowers, like they have down at the courthouse. It's a fairly...
Hey, Bex.
What is it, Quentin?
Nothing really, just, you know, checking in.
Dude, what the hell? I saw you like 10 minutes ago. Also, kinda busy here.
Right, sorry. Stupid.
Okay, I'm getting started. Keep those zombies off my back if you can. Better get ready. We'll be on them soon if we keep going this way.
Hey, we got some trouble out by the shed.
Can't we deal with this later?
Not if you want to finish them towers. We got zombies harassing the guys bringing out the materials. Makes out a lot of zombies harassing our guys.
God damn it. Come on, then. We better go bail them out.
Break this fucking skull!
Zombies up ahead. Go through, go around.
I could really use some help here, boss.
Anyways, like I was saying, the watchtowers were my idea, but Quentin designed them. He's pretty clever when it comes to building stuff. With girls, not so much.
Trouble in paradise.
God, don't get me started. So the other night we had a pretty close call, right? I mean, zombies were inside. We were all freak.
Better deal with this first. So, anyways.
I mean, zombies were inside. We were all freaked. So we raided the liquor department afterwards, just to take the edge off, you know?
Go on.
So, yeah. We both drank more than we probably should, and there's this couch in the manager's office, and... yeah. But now he's doing this whole lost puppy thing, following me around, and acting like we're married or whatever.
Okay, we got some more materials headed your way. They're loaded down pretty good, though. An escort would be helpful.
That's up ahead. I'm about half done here.
Shit, I don't know. I mean, he seems like a nice enough guy, but it was just sex, you know? And if he doesn't knock off this clinging vine thing, I think I might throttle him.
So, how's it coming out there?
See what I mean?
Watch behind us.
That gonna do you?
Should give us some protection anyways. We would have lost a lot of people without you. That counts for something in my book. Anyway, thanks for the... oh, what the fuck? Hold it right there. Hands where we can see him.
Whoa. Easy there, Alex. It's me, Sheriff Carl. Look, we don't want any trouble. We're just here to talk.
Yeah, you wasted a trip. Turn around, walk away, and forget you ever saw this place.
Huh? Wait, who's Alex?
Forget it. We're not interested in signing up with your little society.
Ease up, Becca. Not everybody's out to kill us and take our stuff.
It doesn't take everybody. Just one.
All right. We'll go. We're not here to pressure anybody. You folks stay safe now. Hope you're keeping your nose clean, Alex. You holding up okay? Yeah. Me neither. Man, I don't know how much longer I can take this. You know I had to shoot Frank last week after he turned, right?
That's terrible. If there's anything I can do, just ask.
Now every time we lose somebody, all I can think is... God, I hope I don't have to shoot them in the head. Is that terrible?
No, it makes perfect sense.
Thanks. Good to know I'm not a heartless monster.
Need something?
What's a good word?
There are still a few things to do out there.
Need something?
Your dad.
He was amazing. I know it must have been hard for him after Mom died, but he never let me forget. I remember this one time when I was too sick to go to the movies for Becky Lindemann's birthday party. He turned our living room into an old-timey movie theater, just for me. Popcorn machine, candy, curtains in front of the TV. He even made me get a ticket.
Sounds nice.
I was 14. It was totally lame.
I'll run this home.
We'll be ready.
Town is you're making quite a splash for yourself, my friend. You might not know me yet, but I think the two of us could do each other a lot of good. Why don't you come down to Marshall so we can have a little face-to-face chat?
I think it's one of these. I see something. Looks like an infestation. It's one of these. Thank you.
plastic watch with cartoon fish on it. Perfect.
Something. It's that Cleo person again, but a lot fainter. Now listen.
This is Cleo. Order derived. Rucio Angels 40, 10 mics. Posit 11 Tango Mike Papa 25 Delta 05 Papa.
I keep hearing it every few minutes, but there are still a few things to do out there.
I need a breather. Can't do that right now. I'm almost there.
Considered, I think we're doing pretty okay. Never leave a man behind. Zed gets to go hungry tonight.
Hey, you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Should we?
I'm on it.
Cool. Let's head down towards Marshall. I think I know a place that might suit us. Or we can just drive around for a while and see what we see. Your call.
What was that with you and Lily?
It's a long story. Well, there's not much on the radio to fill the time. Good point. Our mom died when I was 13. Lily was 9.
Sorry.
Yeah. Anyways, not long after that was when Lily was diagnosed. Our dad, he was, he's kind of a wreck. I had to pick up a lot of that slack.
Jacob, I need you to be a man. Help take care of your sister. You know what I mean?
It was a lot for a kid to live up to. I didn't handle it well. And as soon as I turned 18, I told my dad that I was moving to Danforth and I was going to college.
What happened?
Oh, man. Man, he blew up. We had a huge fight, didn't talk for years after that. I finally got back in touch with him just a couple of months ago, actually. This is my first visit home. Anyway, I don't think Lily's quite forgiven me yet. That's the kind of place that we could really stretch out in.
Yeah, but could you imagine how many people we'd need to keep it secure? Without a scratch? Grab it!
This area is secure.
Well, what do you think? Check this place out. It's got a big yard, a privacy wall that we could fortify pretty easily. And check out that tree fort. We could turn that into a watchtower easy.
You seem awfully excited about this place.
Yeah, when I was a kid, my best friend Sally, she lived in this house. And I was so jealous. I always wanted to live here. Well, then let's take a look inside. Jesus!
Who's... I can't see. Help me.
What the hell was that?
Dunno.
That didn't look like any disease I've ever seen. You?
No way.
Maybe we gotta go, huh? Well, that's a few options at least. There might be more out there if you look around. I'll think about it. Sure. Big decision, I get it. Just remember, Tree Fort.
Hey, it's okay. I'm a patient man and you're busy, but I really would like to talk to you.
I need a breather. Where the hell am I gonna carry this?
So damn tired.
This is good, right? I mean, it doesn't suck.
Better do one more sweep. Make sure everything's clear. I'm almost there.
We'll crack.
Found this while I was out.
My hero.
Okay.
I think I'm ready to head home now. Hey, don't be a stranger.
You seem troubled. Is, everything all right?
Huh? Oh, yeah, I'm fine. Just, you know, worried in general.
Well, as it says in Revelation, fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the demons shall cast some of you into prison that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life.
Are you okay?
Seems like we've started to turn a corner. Showed those sons of bitches what's what.
Somebody's broadcasting something.
Charlie Actual, this is Charlie 6. We got a bunch of civilians heavily engaged with Zed about a half click down from our position, requesting permission to assist.
Negative, Charlie 6. Say again, negative. Remain on station.
My ass remain on station. These people are getting their asses handed to them. Do you hear me, Charlie Actual? Charlie Actual,